Hey, how are you doing? Welcome everybody to my live stream for Craster from the Song of Fire and Ice, Freak Folk, Static Set Expansion, whatever. If you have any question, just let me know and I explain. Yeah, Mattis, I know it's wrong, sorry. I do my very best, sorry. If you guys have some question, feel free. Right now I'm using, as you can see, or saw, heavy brown. This is for the sword handle. So this will be my base color. Like this. First of all, when you start painting such miniatures like Craster, it's really important to start with the base colors and block out everything, like the largest areas, like his clothes, parts of the skin. For the skin, I'm using the base color Flat Earth from the model color acrylics from Vallejo. Hey, Lewis. Glad you like your music, finally. Yeah, actually, the music in my first video was a bit my own taste, but not the audience taste. So, with this kind of music, I think I'm doing it a little bit better. So, if you have any questions about how I paint this miniature or how I start, just let me know. I'm really sorry, I can't tell you who this is because it's copyright free music I'm using, so have to check it out later on, maybe. Yeah, I think it's Moniz. I'm gonna explain what I've done here on his chest, or better on his belly. As you can notice or see on this corner here, I just add a little bit of shadow by mixing khaki and black together to get a little bit grayish color, just with a little bit of black in it, to apply it randomly over his side. I think next time the whole Discord channel is up here on my stream. This for sure, when I receive finally the first wave, I will start with a dragon, maybe with some buildings or some infantry, I don't know, we'll see what I will do at least. But yeah, for sure I will start with the Joan of Arc stuff. Yeah, why not? I think AZ will join in today. Yeah, I totally agree. But for me, it's just a pure pleasure to paint such large miniatures. Will take a while, but I think we'll have fun with it. Painting in a group is always important for me as a teacher. It's really important to paint in large groups, like almost 20 people. That's why I teach my way of painting. I think it's really, really important to paint in groups, smaller groups like 2 or 4 people, or larger groups like 10 or maybe 20 people, because each individual person pushes the other one over the boundaries to improve their own style. With my help, they even improve it. And I'm not this kind of painter who hide behind a carpet or anything else like how I paint. It's not magic, it's just training, practice, whatever. And I really want to show people what you can achieve with a brush and paint. Oh, thank you. Actually, I'm doing my very best to speak as fluently as I could or can, whatever. Okay. Oh, thank you. I will head over to the skin tone. Possibly we call it their own nemesis. As I mentioned before, I used flat earth as base color. This time I'm using sunny skin tone and mix it a bit into the flat earth. It's from Song of Fire and Ice, the board game from Cool Mini on that. See, no. Yeah. if you want those, I can explain how I achieve this part of the skin tone or how I start. These are the first colors I use for my skin tone method. This is the base color. Later on, for the first highlight, mixing sunny skin tone into the flat earth. Next up is dead white into mix dead white into sunny skin tone and flat earth to get my second highlight. It's important when you do skin tones that you paint only on the forehead, on the nose bone, and also on the cheeks, and like this part here, the light drops on this upper part. Not on the back of the of his hand, and only on his finger, so that you get a shadow transition. I think those everybody makes mistakes by speaking different words or meanings not correctly. That's my issue, maybe. But after a while, I think I found the correct words in the correct order. So, we are all human, so we are not perfect or special or anything like that. Andrew, how you doing, mate? Glad to have you here. Ah, sorry to hear that Leeds lost. Long ago, since I was in Leeds. Okay, I only saw the airport, nothing more. let's see if I can reduce the brightness so that everybody can see what I achieved right now. Let's see. I'm ready, we are not done yet. There's so much to do on him. I only prepared the face, the beard, the hair, a little bit of the skin on his arm, like up here. But the skin is not done yet. My wife is yelling in the background. She's playing a game. And it sounds like she's still losing against the CPU. And my cat is, and also my cat is running on the background somewhere. I don't know. Can't see it. I only hear her. It's not my fault. I think it's tea time, isn't it, Earl Grey? You're totally right, Bree. Well, now it's time for the funny part. Vice is almost done, but as you can see on his artwork, the face is a little bit reddish. So what I will do is to give this face this reddish look also on his nose. So we'll use heavy red and start thinning it down. Also adds a little bit of purple, like a glaze on his face, on the forehead. We'll use the same technique with the glaze on his face onto his arm. for a better visual, I posted the picture of the right now progress on the Discord channel. Yeah, that's the main issue of web streaming. The whole video will be compiled lower from lower quality. That's the main issue of web streaming already. Now my final, or better, my funniest part is to paint the gold handle and the gold knob of the sword. On the original artwork, it's more silver or more metal steel, but in this case I will do it with a gold effect. So these are the four colors I'm actually using for my momentary gold: heavy brown, mahogany, heavy gold brown, and white. So the first base color is set with heavy brown, and the next step will be adding mahogany to the handle and the knob. So the whole appearance will change into a more reddish, darkish brown tone. Okay, some bit on the hair, that's not good. Okay. Top of the handle. So that it looks like this. Thank you. now I'm mixing the heavy gold round into the Mahogany to create a mid-tone. Ah, now it's a heat gun. Actually, you can use a hairdryer for drying the paint faster, but in this case, I'm using my heat gun. And that's basically how I do Nomentelli Gold. But I will change just a little bit on the front handle, because there's too much of the dog area. Thank you. Oh, yeah, thanks. Could it be in that AZ? Ah, finally, you made it. I'm glad you're here. I'm finally that you finished all the work, and I totally agree. Thanks. I'm totally agree with you about lots of work. When I look at my back, there's tons of work to do for the couple of next months. I told you guys AZ will be here. If I told you what kind of palette I'm using, you'll roll up your eyes. Seb Levine, I'm using just a plastic box, nothing more. No web palette or anything like that. I'm not this kind of guy who would use a web palette. I'm running fine with this. Yeah, absolutely. Bob Ross is, how could I say? The best example how to use a palette on his hand or without any wet pellet. So I think a wet pellet is good though, but for me, I really like this plastic box. Actually, I could use my airbrush to finalize the blades, but I will do it with wet blending this time, with a different kind of style. Some red, purple, green. Thank you. Aubrey, that is really important for me that people see how I do certain effects like the handle and the knob of the sword on the non-metallic gold effect. This is just one way, but there are so many other ways to achieve non-metallic gold effects in certain, or like non-metallic silver. You can do non-metallic silver in many ways. Most people do only one reflection, but if you see some real references on the sword or an armor plate, chest plate, whatever, you see that the light reflects on the whole armor itself and changes the way where the light appears. What I can say is take your time when you try out new things. That's how I proceed on every miniature I paint. Start only first with the base color and try to mix the next color you want to choose into the base color to see how they react and how they change. That's an initial way to proceed further. But anyway, you can ask me at all time, only when I sleep. If you have any question, just feel free to ask. now we're getting the effects, or now I get the effect I really want. The middle of the bloodline. Our reflection here, shadows down there. Ah, Isaiah, wish you an awesome evening. Thanks for joining in, and hope to see you soon. And let's talk. We can talk later, maybe. And wish you a good evening. Craster will take at least 20 minutes, and he's done. Okay, guys, we are almost done. Only the chairs only left, and a few changes here and there. Thank you. final touches and we are done. There, just a little bit. There. Thanks, Lewis. So, as you can see, it took me 2 hours to fully finish this guy on a really high painting level. I will post up pictures around from all around the angles in the Discord channel, and I'm hoping you have had a lot of fun. See how I paint miniatures like that, and that's not the only one. You will see in the next couple of live streams and videos. So next up will be writing an article about these certain effects, like on the handle, on the knob, and how I do faces or worn off closes. Oh, this is just an example. Aubrey, you're absolutely welcome. If you have any question at any time, as I said before, just hit me up and I'll help out as good as I can. So guys, I wish you an awesome evening and thanks for joining in and watching and learning, hopefully. I will announce the next stream in a couple of days and what I will paint next up on my live stream. So I wish you all the best and talk to you on the Discord channel, and of course see you soon.